Hey, what's up, JoJo in the morning? Hope everybody's having a really, really good day. It's going to be a fun time that we get to spend together. I'm wearing my Destiny shirt. I don't know what it is about this shirt, but I just feel Destiny today. I want to talk to you about something that's going to help you, especially on a Monday morning. I love Mondays. Why do I love Mondays? Because I get to do it all over again. When you create the life that God intended you to live, you will absolutely love Mondays. Some people hate Mondays. When people say they hate Mondays, it probably means they ain't living the life that God called them to. Okay, I love you. I'm gonna give you real talk. I love my life. It's taken me years to position my family spiritually, physically, financially, emotionally, just like everybody. We've worked through stuff, but we have positioned ourselves to thrive in life for the kingdom of God. Now, I was in corporate prayer the other night. Woo, man. We were going at it in prayer, and it was so powerful. And I heard the Holy Spirit say, redeem the times. Man, I just kept praying. I heard the Lord say, redeem the times. I just kept praying, and I heard the Lord say, redeem the times. And I'm like, okay, we're about to redeem some times. So think about this. Whenever you get a prophetic word over your life, you are in charge of your life to get yourself in the proper position to do everything that God has called you to do. That's why I do a few certain things every day. Pray in the Spirit, read the Word, listen to the right podcasts, YouTube videos, listen to the right stuff, get the right things inside of me. I got a lot of great friends that send me videos that they watch, that they listen to, that they think would help me. You got to position the right people around you, okay? I want to talk to you about redeem the times. Some of you are currently in the state of positioning yourself to be able to redeem the times. You ever see somebody who's restoring an old car? And so they're restoring their car and they replace a part and they replace another part and then they replace another part and then they may start the car up and they may rev it up and they say, ooh, sounding good. We're not quite there. They replace this, replace. What are they doing? They are rebuilding it to redeem the times. Have you ever seen a car at like a car show? About where our church is at, we have a certain restaurant that has a lot of car shows. And you'll see something like a 67. Well, that's an older car. But that car is polished to the T. Looks like it's showroom floor ready. What did they do? They loved for that car. They cared for that car. They redeemed that car. They restored that car. Okay? So let's get into this. Ephesians 5, 15, 16. So be very careful how you live, not being like those who have no understanding. Some people are living a life. They have squandered their life. They've wasted their life. And they're not even wanting to redeem the times. But live honorably with true wisdom, for we are living in evil times. Listen, evil is everywhere. It's lurking around us, friends. It's everywhere. If you give in to the evilness that's around us, the demonic, the confusing, the frustrating, the toxic, you're going to have some redeeming of the times because you're going to waste some time. It said, but we are living in evil times. Take full advantage of every day as you spend your life on His purpose, not your purpose, not your destiny, His destiny for you. Okay, redeem means to regain possession of something. Well, what is one of the main things people need to regain possession of? Their mind. So many people have given their mind. Listen, when fear controls you, the devil controls you. When faith controls you, God controls you. You know, a lot of people don't like what they call faith preachers. They say they're arrogant. They say they're boasting. Most faith preachers that I know have extreme history with God. I went through this, but I came out. I went through that, but I came out. They came against me, but I came out. They got faith because they have went past circumstances and situations, trials, tests, all that stuff. You got to hear me. One of my dearest, closest friends in the world is an amazing, amazing man of God. He's kingdom minister. He's an apostle. He rolls with a lot of people in what they call the faith movement. And he was driving to an event that he was preaching at a very large gathering. Something happened. His car spun out of control, wrecked his car, totaled his car, stepped out of his car, preached 45 minutes later, not a scratch on him. A lot of people say, how did you do that? He said, when I was in the midst of my car spinning out of control, I knew I had an assignment to preach. I knew I was going to be fine. I had faith. Even though there was a wreck, it could have ruined the meeting. God's got it. Some of you have allowed fear to conquer you. Therefore, you need God to redeem the times. Some people were going hard after God at one point in their life, and then they stopped and they just coasted. God's about to redeem the times. A lot of people have had, just your marriage has been so-so over the last few days, months, weeks, years. You need to redeem the times. You need to redeem the times, my friend. You need to redeem the times in your ministry. You were thankful for God for that job. Now you complain about it. Now you just kind of just, you know, mill around. Know it's time that you redeem the times. I read something the other day. It was really good. It said, do everything that you can to make up for lost territory. Some of you, God put you in a certain job to be a minister there. Some of you are in ministry and you're not doing anything for your territory. Make the most of every moment that you have right now and do everything you can to recover those precious moments and opportunities that you thought were lost forever, but they are not lost forever because we serve a God who's going to redeem the times. Woo! Redeem the times. I was praying about something the other day, and then the Lord gave me a dream about what I was praying for. And the way the dream, it was very plain, and it just shone. I was like, my God, how powerful. You are about to redeem the times. I was given prophecies 15 years ago about a few certain things. And I had a lot of people in places of power in churches and ministries come against me in a very rough way. And they thought they pushed me to the side, but the Holy Spirit showed me recently how he was redeeming the times. I'm telling you, that what I just read, some of you thought you lost something. Listen, no man can stop you. Sometimes the devil can use people to delay you, to push you back. But I'm telling you, it's your season. God is about to redeem the times in your life. I was praying for somebody recently. And just Spirit of the Lord came over me. And I said, what you're about to do in the next 3 years is going to overshadow what you've done in the last 20. Think about that. 3 years versus 20 years. A lot of people are about to start doing that. On the flip side, people that have been doing ministry out of the natural, you'll probably do the same amount in the next 20 that you did in the last three. This is how it is. A lot of businesses were birthed out of the place of prayer. God put a word on somebody's heart. They went in the business. They got a little successful in the business. Kind of walked away from God. You better listen to the Lord in the days ahead. They're not going to be the easiest days. But they're going to be good days. You better make sure that you're positioned with God for the future. God's got a plan, and you and I are a part of it. The enemy has pushed you back. The enemy, it's John 10:10. The enemy came to kill, steal, and destroy, but my God came to give life and life more abundantly. You better get ready for the rest of 2022, 2023, 2024. God is going to do some great things. Ephesians 6:10. God wants to do an explosive work in you, first of all, then to do it through you. Okay? So get ready. This is a season that God is going to do a powerful. Out of everything that we do, the most powerful thing that I do is keep my walk with God strong. The fire burning on the inside of me strong. And I keep it strong in the place of prayer. Leviticus, it talks about how that the fire on the altar should never go out. You keep your heart burning for God in that place of prayer. I bet 90% of what I do comes out of my early morning prayer. He just speaks to me. And then what he speaks to me, I go implement. Pretty simple philosophy. So what Jesus did, you know, Mark 1:35, Jesus got up early in the morning, went to a solitary place where he prayed. One translation says, Jesus got up early in the morning, left the house where he was, departed, went to a place basically where nobody could find him, and prayed. If it's good enough for Jesus, it's good enough for me. Oh, man, I'm going to spend that early morning time with the Lord. When you do, that's where your strength will come from. Here, let me give you a little insight on my life. I never go to God for a message. I never go to God for a prophetic word. I go to God for God, and he just speaks to me. I never go to God for business ideas. He just speaks to me. Kind of neat how that works. I love you guys. This was a Monday morning coming at you, JoJo in the morning. Redeem the times. Claim that word and go get it.